So over the next few years, there'll be challenges and new challenges for the industry. What do you think they're going to be?
We've probably seen it a little bit this last 18 months to 2 years. Procurement comes into it.
Right, okay. Do you want to elaborate on that for me?
Oh, a little bit. You get big organisations, get guys who've been trained on procurement coming into it, trying to treat this industry as a little bit like the car industry.
Right, okay.
Dealers are factory owned. Well, that's not the case. Most dealers are family businesses. Yeah, they've all grown.
Yeah.
But they're still, end of the day, family businesses. And it's them guys who speculate to accumulate.
They're trying to trade with you as if it's a commodity rather than a specialist
business. Not the price down. You know, we're all in business to make money.
Yeah.
It's not a big volume industry. Can't really say much more at the moment on that.
I'm not asking you to go into territory that is challenging.
It's challenging. We also see local authorities cutbacks. Well, once you get to the bone, you can't pare it much more.
No, that's true.
We see the standards of local authority football pitches despicable.
Okay.
I've seen what's happened in Europe over 40 years. They've come from very, very poor quality to excellent quality. They've got their act together.
And is that act together in terms of the quality of the groundsman, or is it the way that they're structuring?
It's way it's structured. There might be not so many groundsmen, but a lot of contractors in Europe, very, very good contractors who are building and looking after sports complexes. They built right, they haven't cut corners, built with the right materials. All too often we see it's a brownfield site, been levelled off, 6 inches of topsoil have been put on, drains that don't connect or drains that run uphill. You know, water does go the other way. Very, very badly constructed.
Okay.
We see too much of that in the UK.
So, Campey, how's it going to help meet those challenges? I mean, I guess in terms of the infrastructure, there's not a lot you can do to change that, but I guess, are you going to try and educate those people that are buying from you?
I try, but some are beyond educating. Some local authority people. We've offered to take them over to Holland, France, have a look, speak to people. They think that's corruption.
Really? Okay. Yeah.
They can't travel. I don't really know how a lot of local authority people are going there.
So if you work for a local authority and somebody says you can come over here and learn how to be better at your job, you're not allowed to do it.
Not allowed to do it.
Okay, that's a real shame.
It is.
You feel like you're banging your head against a brick wall.
Yeah. All the good guys, knowledgeable guys, have gone. They've left it. Took retirement, redundancy. People are in charge. You. What have it's tagged on to environmental health?
Yeah.
Grounds maintenance doesn't come into it.
So quality is very much secondary to budgetary concerns.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. And that has an impact on not just sport and leisure for people, has an impact on health as well. Because
without a doubt, the government on one hand are pushing more physical training, or not training, playing football or sport.
Activity, keep people off the national health books.
If the pitches or the parks areas aren't up to scratch, your kids won't play. They'll play on a computer.
Yeah.
They won't play
and
sport.
It's sad, it is. Mm. And you look at Europe and you look at Australia and you look at other places where they seem to have just got it flipped the other way around.
I'm not saying it's every local authority, but there's a hell of a lot in this Northwest England that don't meet any standards.